Good day, fellow YouTubians. This is funnyeehn back with a... Well, actually, this is a dance video reminder because today is already Thursday night. Might even be Friday morning by the time this is up. And I have been asking for you guys to provide those dance videos for that specific kind of video that I'm doing, going to be editing this weekend. And so this is just a reminder for you guys to send those in. I'll leave a link to my... I guess you can say my instructional video about that, of how to go about that, underneath the video description for this. But anyway, so I wanted to remind you guys of that, first of all, because that's coming up, and Friday is only one more day. So I want to get those videos in as soon as possible. But I figured since I was here, I haven't done any Darkest of Days straight-up gameplay for a long time. So I'm finally going to do some more. So yeah, let's do it.
Here's the deal. Those agents, well... call them that have been hassling you, are turning into a major problem. We need to figure out where they're coming from, who they're working for, and what the hell they're packing for heat. Now, I don't like this a whole lot, but we're up against it, and this is what we gotta do. I've scouted out a ravine where some cavalry boys are getting their asses handed to them by the Indians. I want you to clear out the Indians, and then, well, you need to take out the soldiers with blue auras. And that'll grab the attention of those agent boys. They're gonna come after you, and you're playing rabbit. Lead them up through the ravine, and I'll take care of the rest.
Alrighty. Can do. And as always, let's go to the bubble. Bubble, yes! Transport me to another time, bubble. Yeah, I probably wouldn't feel so good having all that bubbleness inside your mouth. Okay, I'm gonna stop there. Right, that was a bad decision to say it. Say that. Follow me. So, I got some pretty good weapons I'm starting off with. I'm satisfied as of now. But, oh yeah, that's right. We got these little trap things going on. What we got here? Ooh, it's pretty.
Oh. All right, this is the spot.
Wait, you're that's not me.
To lead them here. Right now, let's head up there and take a look around.
I was like, why do I look like Dexter? Oh, because that is Dexter. That's funny. Okay, so let's follow the serial killer Dexter. No, just kidding. I'm not sure if any of you guys used to watch... Well, I guess technically you can still watch that show, Dexter. It's about... is it HBO Showtime? I haven't watched in so long. I just don't even remember. But Dexter is about that serial killer guy. And... used to be one of my favorite shows. I really enjoyed it. Really cool character and stuff. Anyway.
Yeah, this looks good. I'll be able to cover you from up here if you stick to the ravines on your way back. Take a good look and check your map. You're gonna have a few of those shiny shitheads on your tail when you come back through. Now the cavalry targets should be that way. And we're gonna wanna... Shit! Did you hear that? Gotta be an Indian patrol. Get...
Oh, whoa, jeez. Jeez. Where are those? How can you even throw them that far? I mean, how ridiculous is that, you know? Is that somebody down there? I think so. Okay, so I guess I'm supposed to go down there. Oh, no, they're behind us. Worse yet. Alright, so, as you... Oh, excuse me. Ugh, that's what you get for having carbonated drinks. Anyway, oh man, I'm just burpy right now. So, anyway, looks like... as you might, for those of you that have not followed my previous additions to this... Oh my gosh, I have an arrow in my stomach! Ow! That looks terrible. Alright, well, I'm going to press on, because I'm a boss, and that's what a boss does. Oh my goodness, what are you doing, you people? Hmm? See, I'm trying to remember what the melee attack is. Is F? Yeah, it's F. You know, you just get confused. You start playing so many different games, just don't even know what's going on anymore. Alright, so, gotta locate the target. Oh! I don't trust you. Sorry, buddy. I think you would have thrown, like a... Well, it wouldn't be a harpoon, because that would be underwater. But... Oh! I'm not doing so good. Yeah. That arrow just cracks me up, man. Man, you can take a few bullets there, my friend. I give you props, my Native American friend. I mean, I guess it really doesn't make sense, does it? You don't usually call your friend somebody who you kill. You know, let's not think about that. Let us continue on the mission. You know, we don't want to... Oh no. Let's try not to die. Oh, I think he covered me. Dexter, you're a good man. You're a good man. You can cover me. You know, I really don't think I shot the horse. That's just my... Oh. Uh-oh. Native Americans on my butt. And they don't like me because I'm different. No, actually, because I'm... Probably because I'm white. And we all know... Interesting. I don't even know how to handle this right now. Do I kill you? I don't know. Are you people bad? Is everyone bad? Oh, no. You know, it looks like the horse just... Oh, hello. Jeez. You know, it looks like the horse just literally fell over. Just, like, flopped over. Look, its legs are completely straight. Oh, man. Graphical details. I tell you, they are important. Yes. I don't even know what to say to that. Are you okay? Oh, you gonna take a nap? I'm pretty sure he just took a nap. Because that definitely didn't look like he died. That looked like he took a nap. Alright, so... I'll let you guys do your thing. I don't think I have any grenades. No, I don't. So this is not going to be fun for you. I'm sorry. Excuse me. Are you, do you like me? I guess you are my friend. I don't know who's my friend and who isn't. I really don't. I mean, as far as I knew, everyone was my enemy, but I guess not. Which is good. It's good to have friends in life. I'm a firm believer in this. And I don't think I'm supposed to go this way. No, you know, actually, I take that back. I think I am supposed to go that way. And, maybe I just need to find a more appropriate direction. Perhaps this way. Yes. Yes. See, I knew I was supposed to go this way. I'm sorry, pal.
Thank goodness, you came just in time.
Sorry. That was a sad thing to do. Okay, so I have to lure the opposition into the trap. It's a trap! As our favorite Star Wars character used to say. Let's see. Okay. I get the point, guys. I know you guys don't like me. But still, there's no need for the violence. Okay. Hey, listen, shield buddy. I just want to let you know right now, I think that's unfair that you have a shield and I don't. You know, I mean, I promote equality in life. You know, equal opportunity. Uh-oh. I guess they don't really care much for my freedom and American speech. Oh, shoot. Am I going the wrong way? Oh, no. I think I went the wrong way. Let's try this again. I can't be too far from my last checkpoint. I think. Oh, is it supposed to go this way? It's so confusing, because I don't remember. Wait, so I need... No, I think I need to go that way. I really do. Alright. How am I supposed to get through there? If these dicks keep on shooting me, you know? Okay, alright, so I was going the right direction. That's what you get. That's what I get for questioning myself. Come on, boy. Come on. You have been bubbled. How's that make you feel? Do you feel sticky? Because that's what, you know, that's what bubbles make you feel like after you blow bubbles. You know, it's that sticky, kind of gross. I don't even know how to describe that stuff. I really don't. Okay, Dexter.
We got him. Good work, son.
Oh, thanks.
You managed to keep your poop with a group under fire.
Keep your poop.
I might even be proud of you right.
See, I don't understand is why he says poop now after all those times he just would swear. Like, I just don't get it. It's like, oh, now I'm going to be all polite and say, you held your poop in. I'm feeling some character inequalities. Not inequalities.
It's such a joy to welcome back my triumphant warriors. Well done. The both
Whatever.
Of you. Our investigators are going to work with our new guest and see what we can learn. We have not had a chance to do any research yet, but we do already know their shield resonance.
That is that how you feel?
To take them down twice as effectively. That should even out the playing field, as I assume you will encounter them again.
Yes.
Much work still needs to be done. Both Welsh and Petrovich are still out there, but now I can confidently send you to get it done. Mm-hmm. Dexter, whatever plan you put together worked very well.
Please keep up
the good work.
You trusted me and didn't say anything.
Your mouth
I appreciate that,
very
so
scary.
I'm going to let you in on what's going on.
I can't see any details.
Do you wonder why you're here? Or why I'm here?
No.
Well, we're a couple of history mysteries, the two of us.
Mm-hmm.
Like you at Little Bighorn.
Yeah.
You were about ready to buy the farm. But since you were just transferred from a different unit and arrived early, history shows you as an MIA from your previous unit.
Yeah.
The lists of the dead and missing from Custer's last stand don't have your name. As far as history's concerned,
you're talking to
you're
I'm
a
over
ghost.
Here, buddy.
And perfect for snatching by Cronenberg.
Look at me when I'm talking
just
to
like
you.
Me.
Dexter.
I was a firefighter in New York City. It was an exciting job. Dangerous, but it was worth it.
Mm-hmm.
And on that fateful day, I wasn't working. Wasn't even on call. But I heard the scanner and I knew I had to respond. And right before a kajillion tons of steel and concrete collapsed on top of me, a portal appeared and a Chronotech agent pulled me in. Just like you. If Chronotech hadn't snagged me, I'd be dead. So, as the MIAs of history, we're allowed to go back and set things right with history, while the rest of the Chronotech folks can't. They're stuck. They have to use us MIAs that are never figured out. Pretty deep, huh?
Yep.
And there's more of us. The research team is concentrating on finding and retrieving other ghosts of time. One piece of advice. If she offers to send you back to your original time, don't take it. You'll be sent to the exact moment you left. In your case, about 10 seconds before an Indian splits open your skull.
Ooh.
When it comes to working for Chronotech, you're damned if you do, and dead if you don't.
Mm-hmm.
How's that for a motivational slogan, huh? Yeah, well, sorry for the history lesson. We have work to do. Where do you want to start?
See, that's actually one of the reasons I really enjoyed this game. Not only for, obviously, the concept of going back in time, but I thought they did a good job at establishing a storyline that had a original feel to it.
The one about a
the ideas were
Rabbi and Abraham Lincoln walking into a bar.
I gotta listen to his joke.
The bartender looks at him and says, "What is this? Some kind of joke?"
Anyway, so yeah, this is just. I mean, I just really like the way they went about the story and everything. So that's one of the reasons I like it, and that's why I continue to play it, because it's just a cool concept, fun game, and it's just fun. So anyway, guys, that is it for this episode. Once again, I want to remind you guys to do those dance videos, because I got a day left that I am putting out there, and I want to get editing to that video as soon as possible. So once again, I will have the more specific instructional video underneath the link, at least, underneath this video description. And please, please, please get involved. I want to get you guys involved and just have a great time with it. But anyway, guys, I will talk to y'all later, and this is funnyeehn, signing out.